Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair. Guys, in today's video, guys, we're going to review something, guys, a mistake that 9 out of 10 people will make. 90% of the people make that mistake, guys, when you remove cylinder head, when you're replacing cylinder head or cylinder head gasket. Something very important to you guys. Okay, and let's explain why now. Most mechanics even, guys, do not know that, and I found it not too long ago as well, and I decided to share it with you. If you're guys removing cylinder head, if you're removing cylinder head gaskets, anything like that on any car, guys, does it really matter how you remove it? You know, guys, there is a special pattern bolt sequence when you install your cylinder head gasket, and there is a special torque specs as well. Why? This is because, guys, if you do not apply even amount of pressure, okay, on each side of the head, what will happen? The head will deform. Something that you cannot see with your eye, but it will deform enough that you can develop a gasket leak, okay, and have head gasket problems. And the only way to fix that is go to the machine shop and resurface the head. Now, okay, but what about removing the cylinder head, guys? Okay, let's say you need to put a new gasket, or you need to replace a piston, rings, or anything like that. You will need to remove your cylinder head. And most people, guys, 9 out of 10 people, will just start removing the bolts. Okay, all the way, from left to right, right to left, or just randomly removing bolts. No, guys, there is a way to do that. We will be demonstrating on a 4-cylinder engine, but 3, 4, 6, and 8 cylinders will be that way. Now, as you know, guys, 4-cylinder engine has 10 bolts on the cylinder head. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 bolts. Most of them will be that way. 3-cylinder engines, they have 8 bolts. V6 engine, guys, it's composed of like 2 3-cylinder heads. Okay, so as a result, each head will have about 8 bolts. And V8 will be like having 2 of those heads. So each head will have 10 bolts. Now, how you guys remove the cylinder head without causing any damage? Let me, guys, explain to you now in just a second. So we're going to, guys, okay, right here now, the bolt sequence and all that, and let's explain why now. Okay, so we have, guys, okay, on the bottom, okay, we're going to have bolt 1, bolt 2, we have bolt 3, bolt 4, bolt 5, bolt 6, bolt 7, bolt 8, bolt 9, and 10 in the middle. So now we are not done, guys. You have to stay until the end because there is a catch now, and I will explain why. Okay, let me just make sure that thing doesn't fly away. So, how you guys, okay, remove that thing now. So you can see this is the sequence right here, the way you remove it. 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. But what else you need to do, guys? You need to do it in 2 different steps. And how is that? Step number 1, guys. Okay, step number 1, you get the bolts loose 90 degrees. What is, guys, considered 90 degrees now? 90 degrees is quarter of revolution, guys. Okay, just like that. This is 90 degrees. You're going to start on bolt 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What is step number 2? Something super important. Step number 2, guys. Okay, you're going to go ahead and do 180 degrees on all of the bolts in the same sequence we already did. So 180, guys, this is half of a circle. Okay, half of a circle, starting on bolt 1. Okay, it will be starting on this side. You will go all the way down to right here. Half of one circle, half of revolution. This is, guys, 180 degrees. And you start on bolt 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. After that, guys, it doesn't really matter. You can just go ahead and remove them. That way, you will not damage your head, and you will not cause any unwanted damage that can result in expensive repairs later. So thank you for watching, guys, and see you guys next time.